Hello friends, welcome back. Today let us learn about performance analysis. Performance analysis means before executing an algorithm, we have to estimate its performance. Performance is nothing but it is the process of calculating the time and space required by an algorithm. That means it like before calculating or executing an algorithm, we must have an idea about how much space will that algorithm occupy in a system's memory and how much time will that algorithm occupy in order to complete to its execution. That means it is only called as space complexity and time complexity. These two are the major criteria for performance analysis. Now let's go into the concept. Performance analysis is nothing but it is calculating the time and space required by that algorithm. Okay, performance analysis is having two measures. The first one is space complexity and the second one is time complexity. Space complexity is nothing but the space required by an algorithm in order to complete, okay, to its execution. And coming to time complexity, time complexity is nothing but the time required for the algorithm in order to complete its task. Now let's go into detail. Space complexity means when we design an algorithm, it requires the space. Obviously, in order to solve an algorithm, it requires some space. It needs some space in the computer memory, and for any algorithm, space is required. Why means let's see why. For the following purposes is the first purpose is it required the space. The algorithm requires the space in order to store its instructions, in order to store its constant values, and in order to store its variable values. For these purposes we need space for the algorithm. Okay, and space is nothing but, space complexity is nothing but the total amount of the computer's memory which is required for the algorithm in order to complete its execution. Okay, and these are instruction space. Same I repeated here friends, instruction space means nothing but the amount of the memory used to store the instructions in the computer's memory. Okay, and coming to data space. Data space means amount of the memory used in order to store the variables and constants. For example, in order to store the integer value, we need 2 bytes. In order to store the floating value, we need 4 bytes. And in order to store the character's value, we need 1 byte. Fixed component. It is nothing but the, this is independent characteristics of inputs and output. Means, like, the inputs does not depend upon outputs, the outputs does not manipulate the input. This is only called fixed component. Okay, this part means includes instruction space, means the space which are required, which is required in order to save the, store the instruction, and in order to stay store the simple variables and fixed variables or constant variables. Okay, variable part means here the inputs depend upon outputs and the outputs depend upon inputs. This is only called variable component. And see friends, in order to we already know that we have to calculate the space complexity. In order to find the space complexity of the algorithm A, first we have to add fixed components of algorithm A plus variable components of the algorithm A. We already studied what are the fixed components and the variable components. In order to get the space complexity, we need to add these both. Okay, and this is simple algorithm. And coming to time complexity, time complexity is nothing but the time required for an algorithm in order to complete its complete execution. Okay, this only I explained here. Every algorithm requires some amount of computer time in order to execute. This is only called as time complexity, and it is nothing but the total time required in order to execute. And generally running time of algorithm depends upon the following. Let's see what are those. Okay, first point is the time of an algorithm, the time taken by the algorithm is dependent upon the processor. Means if it is a single processor, it will take more time because the same processor should handle all the tasks. So it takes time. And if it is multiprocessor, the task will be completed fastly. So it depends upon how much time it takes based upon single or multiple processor. Okay, and it also depends upon whether it is a 32 bit or 64 bit, and read and write speed also manipulates it. Like if the read and write speed is slow, we can't do anything, it slows down, then the algorithm time it consumes more time, and the time it takes in order to perform arithmetic operations, logical operations, all this also should be considered, and how much time is it taking in order to operate, I mean in that sense, and even assignment operators, like how much time the algorithm is taking in order to assign operator. Okay, and this is the runtime, which is denoted by TP. Here runtime, we have to calculate the runtime, and TP is nothing but it is the denotion of like we are denoting the runtime with TP. TP of n is addition of n, subtraction of n, multiplication of n, and deletion of n. Sorry, division of n, where n is nothing but the instance characters, like they are the characteristics, and CA, CS, CM, and CD are nothing but the time for, like it takes this much time for addition, multiplication, division, and etc. And this is the algorithm for the global count. This is the algorithm, like nothing but, as I discussed in the previous video, it is nothing but algorithm, algorithm name, parameters. We are incrementing the count. If n is less than or equal to 0, then count should be incremented and return 0. Else, count should be incremented and it should return R sum a comma n minus 1 plus a of n. This is nothing but global variable count. That's it for today, friends. Hope you understood this video. Subscribe to my channel for more such videos. Thank you.